Okay, well, let's start with the Hohner 64 combs, the 16-hole chromatics. The combs are all the same. This 64 and the Super 64 have a black comb, and the 64X has a clear comb, but the shape is the same. So what you need is a piece of wood to cut on, and you need a nice sharp cutting blade like that. Now, the power plugs come in a little plastic bag like that, so just open it up and just empty them down on the work surface. So you can see there's a bunch of them in pairs, and then a couple of singles. So those two are the singles there, and these are the ones in the pairs. Now, the paired ones are split because the Hohner 64 and the CX-12 have got these little fins down the middle of the chambers. So what we're going to do is split these pairs and then put one half of each down each side of the, on each side of the fin. Okay, well, how do you sort of work out which is which? There's four different sizes for a start. So obviously you can see there's, a short chamber. The next one is a little bit longer, but a little bit longer. And the power plugs follow the same pattern. To make life a little bit easier for you, I've sort of made the backs of the power plugs a little bit different. That's the shortest one. It's just two power plugs. That's the next one down, which is hole 15. That's got a little notch on one side and nothing on the other. And then the next one down, hole 14, has got notches on both sides. And then you've got these two singles. Now, one of the singles has got a little indentation at its base, and that goes on the top of the comb. The other single has no indentation either side, and that goes on the back of the comb. So let's start at the top. Let's start on hole number 16, which is the very top hole. So basically, just take this the shortest power plug with no indentations. Get your sharp blade and just snip the connecting tab in between the two halves, like that. And then take the right-hand side and just put it into the comb chamber. It should just sit in there really nicely on one side of that fin. And then you get the other half, which is there, and that goes on. Just push the nose in first, and then push down with your thumb at the back. And there it is. It's sitting nestling around that central fin. Okay, we'll do the same with the next hole down, hole number 15. And that's this one here with a flat edge and then the notched edge. Again, we slice this little connecting tab there. The blade. Make sure to cut both sides of it, otherwise they won't sit down properly. And then we have the one side of the power plug. Put the front in first and then the back, and there it is sitting in there. And then the other side. If you want to, you can use something like a toothpick or a screwdriver or whatever, just to make sure the fronts and the backs are sitting down properly. You can see the fronts are sitting down nice and flat. And okay, let's move on to number 14. That's this one here with the two notches. That's the third one down, and again, cut that connecting tab. Same thing again, I'll just zoom out here and pop one side in and the other side. They fit in sort of snugly, but not too, doesn't take too much pressure to put them in. And finally, the single one, and now this is the one with the little indentation, the little hole on the right hand side. This is the one that goes on the top surface of the comb. And that just is one piece, and that just sits in snugly. And there they are, so easy. They're just that's the four top ones. Okay, let's try the other side. So basically, exactly the same process. Maybe we'll start with the shortest one first. You wouldn't believe how long these little buggers took to get right. Incredibly days and days of work, just making tiny little changes to this, that, and the next thing, then finding something was wrong and having to go back and do it all over again. I've done so many prints and iterations of them, it's been driving me mad, but I think I've finally got to the point where they're just perfect. I tried to make them in one piece, but they wouldn't print properly, so I ended up making them in these two nifty little halves, which, you know, are quite cute in their own right. Okay, so that's the third of the pairs. And again, I just press them a little bit with the screwdriver. And finally, the single that goes on the underside. And this is the one with no markings on either side. And that just pops in there. Now, just look from the front to make sure that all the fronts are sitting down, sort of like that. You can see what a radical difference the power plugs make to the interior profiling of these upper chambers. They really fill in all that extra, you know, wasted space. So really, this, the only space that's used is where the reeds go. And okay, and also look towards down towards the back there. Just make sure all the power plugs are below the surface of the comb, because if they're not, that'll push the reed plates off the surface of the comb, and then the harmonica won't be airtight. So you know, just make sure that everything's sitting down flush, or down inside the chambers, and all the fronts are down, and then that's good to go. Basically, ready to put your reed plates on and experience the you know, the enhanced response in that top octave of your Hohner 16-hole chromatic. Okay, let's move on to the Hohner CX-12 now. Now, this is a similar design, but slightly different. You can see that it's only the, in this case, hole number 12 and 11 have got these fins down the middle, and then hole number 10 and 9 don't have any fins. Again, the power plugs come in a little plastic bag. Just liberate them from the bag, and there they are. Now, these ones, you've got the two, in this case you've got four single power plugs, okay, and on one end, as with the 64, you'll see there's a tiny little hole indentation there on one pair of singles. They're the ones that go on the top of the comb, and then on this other pair of singles, there's no indentation, and they go on the bottom of the comb. Okay, well, I'll show you how the singles go on first. They have to wrap around this little screw hole protrusion, and that's why the top and the bottom pair are a little bit different. Okay, we'll start with the top pair. Remember, these are the ones with the little hole on the right hand side. So just get your blade and cut this tab that goes between them. It's just holding them together. Get the one with the hole and put that in hole number 9, and it'll just pop down into the slot there like that. And you can see it sort of wraps around that screw hole protrusion there. And then the one for hole number 10, and similar thing. If you want to, you can use a little screwdriver just to help you push the backs and the fronts down. So that's those two in. Now, with the all of these split ones, these are basically, they can go on the top or the bottom, it doesn't really matter. But there is a difference between them. There's two small ones and two slightly longer ones. The small ones go in hole number 12, and they don't have any indentations on the bases, on the sides. And then the next one, the hole number 11, does have these little notches cut in there. So it's easier to tell them apart. So we'll start with hole number 12, the shortest ones. And as with the 64 power plugs, just use your knife blade and cut that little connecting tab on both sides. And then we can just insert these. So these are going to go in hole 12, the top hole. First one goes in one side, the other goes in the other side. And there they are, just sitting in there beautifully. And then the next one, which is for hole number 11. Same thing again. You can do this with just finger pressure, really. You don't need an extra screwdriver, but it just does give a little bit of extra precision when you're pushing down. So you can see they wrap around those middle fins. So let's do the other side now. Here are your two singles. Again, cut that connecting tab. And you can see that they're a different shape to the ones on the top. And that's why they're indicated with the that little indentation on the top end there. Now this, again, we've got these two slightly different notch. One's that got the little notches and the other's got no notches. So the ones with the notches are going to be in there, hole number 11. Cut that connecting tab on both sides. And then put them in place. And finally, number 12. You get pretty fast at this after a while. It's not difficult. Everything's pretty obvious. And just use some sort of little thing to just press, make sure the backs are pressed down and the fronts are pressed down. Okay, and then if you look from the front, you'll see what a radical difference, again, that's made to the internal profiling of your CX-12. And it's really this area that's the critical one for improving read response. Okay, you're ready to play that thing.